Welcome to the River Mersey. I'm Keith Chesworth, otherwise known as Boiler Bill, and I'll be cutting in and out on my little bit of film with silly bits of description and what have you to help those who have never been there, who've got no idea of things soggy and what have you. So, this film is about the ferry in front of you, the Irish Ferries by P&O at the end, Norseman, and you'll see a little Norfolk Line ferry sculling about. Why Norfolk Line? From the southeast of England to Merseyside on the northwest? I don't know. Okay, the boat in front of you is the Overchurch, which is built in 1962 by Camelards as a Birkenhead ferry. She still has a Birkenhead funnel colours. She's been very much refurbished, and she's been renamed in a Wallasey name of the Royal Daffodil, which comes from Dunkirk. Now, when I grew up, we had the Wallasey ferries with white funnels and the Mersey ferries with red. This one, as a Birkenhead ferry, when Liverpool snatched the whole area into Merseyside, they reformed it into Mersey ferries, so you didn't have Birkenhead and Wallasey anymore, and bit by bit it's been getting snatched, hence the Wallasey name now. So we'll carry on, watch this one coming alongside of the Birkenhead jetty at Woodside, and I'll have a chat with you later. Thanks very much. Turn round and you find that the Norse merchant ship is trying to sneak off behind our backs. Anyway, we won't see any more of her today, but we'll either see her or our sister ship pushing off down the river on Sunday. So, have a quick watch of her. Those little clunks, they seem to indicate that the counterweighted gangway has just been lifted on the Mersey ferry, so she should be pushing off very shortly. Have a careful watch when she does. She almost seems to come off sideways. Now there's no bow thrusters. All that it is twin screws, twin rudders, and using the very, very powerful, fast tide race in the Mersey. It gives this sort of effect. She could almost go across the river sideways. Okay, as we swing round and start running down past the pier head, I'll give you a quick rundown of some of the buildings of reasonable interest that you've probably seen as characteristic Liverpool. These are the new buildings in the southern area of the river frontage, including new courts. I believe there's shopping centres being built, things like this. As we're coming up now, that building in the background is the Liverpool Cathedral. Never completed, they just finished, just built a back end wall and that was it. Massive building. We are next going to be coming up to this thing here, which is Paddy's Wigwam, or the Catholic Cathedral. Liverpool has one to spare. The buildings in front are the Mersey Maritime Museum in the old Albert Docks. The tower is the chimney of the St. John's shopping precinct. That little one just come in now is the old PSNC building. The domes are the Mersey Docks and Harbour Board building. The flat roof building is the original Cunard head office. The one with the clocks on the top are the Royal Liver buildings, Royal Liver Insurance. On top, which you just cut out there, but you'll see them later, are the famous liver birds, which are copper birds, well tied down, but the story about them is that if a good looking 16-year-old young virgin girl walks past, they will fly away. They've been there for well over 100 years. Okay, this lot now is the northern sort of buildings, and we'll finish off there. Thank you very much. There you go. Just starting to pack up, and this nice little pilot boat comes towing into view. Going to do something at the Woodside stage. If you look just across that triangular thing, that's the old Liverpool landing stage for the Mersey ferries, which kind of sunk during the winter. You did see the Mersey ferry quietly sneaking up on the Isle of Man ferry, which it's borrowing for the time being. I'll speak about this boat later. So what we have here is the Royal Daffodil sneaking up into the Isle of Man floating landing stage, which is rather funny really, because once upon a time a pierhead had the biggest or longest floating landing stage in the world to take both ferry boats, Alaman boats, and deep sea ocean liners. And this bit was the Birkenhead ferries, going back before the war, because what it is the old floating roadway, which took all the road transport down to the luggage boats, which was the only way of getting between Liverpool and Birkenhead before the original Mersey tunnel was dug back in the 1930s. And we did just sweep back onto the Alaman boat then, the new high speed boat. And I greet you well too. A quick dash up to Harrison Drive in Wallasey, getting towards the River Estuary, and we find Daffy wandering back down from her little cruise section up towards the mouth of the river. And lo and behold, there's the Alaman steam packet, which is no longer steam, of course, plodding out towards heading off for Douglas. Now, obviously, we are going to have a nice visual picture of these two crossing. Are we? Can anybody please answer a simple question on the facts alive? Like, just when things are getting interesting, we have to kick the bloody tripod over. Again, leave that tripod alone. even if we are sailing downhill. Morning of Sunday the 9th, and the first thing that we notice is Daffy's over in Liverpool firing up, probably for a first run. As you might notice, they're facing towards the river estuary now rather than upriver as they were on Friday, which means that we're in a flood tide rather than neb tide. We're also finding parked up here the Norfolk Line ferry and our friend the Norseman again. Well, we'll see what happens as the day goes on. Well, after a very necessary search for a place and having a quick call of nature, which the doctor tells me is purely stress-induced, one of many, we've moved across slightly to the other side of a redundant dock entrance, or float as they're called up here, and Daffy's plodded across to Birkenhead, parked up facing downriver to the estuary again, and already plodding off. Okay, we've moved back down to Harrison Drive to a nice little observation place by the Wallasey Town Hall. I refuse to say the Wirral because Birkenhead is the leading and the biggest town, regardless of what scumbags in local government or civil servants think or try to rip off. We're immediately rewarded by a view of a little tanker coming down. Quite a nice little view of the sunken landing stage. Daffy over in Liverpool looks like a little pile of boat in front of him. And if we just pull back a bit, I think we'll see the liver birds are still there. So nothing much has happened and all's well in the world. While we're trying to keep things all nice and squared up in the wind, we'll have a nice little long shot out to the estuary, and we're finding this little red boat coming in. Of the glue what or who she is. Swing back, catch Harrison Drive, and we'll wander around and see what's coming up. And we see our little product carrier tanker. She's wandering down past the pierhead, and in the distance behind her, lo and behold, he got another little blue thing. Nicely fully loaded tanker. This one here, of course, is either in heavy ballast or only part loaded. So we'll just have a little park up and watch these things floating past. This is where the POS Canon, that is Canon camera, chewed its last tape before being slung to the bottom of our stairs with great and effective force. The tape has been salvaged by a good old second-hand JVC, same as the last two I had. Coming out makes you almost feel like what it must have been like years ago when the docks were going. A little taste at least. Announcement. This is the end of this leg of the trip. All those passengers not in possession of a valid return ticket are requested to leave the boat immediately. The gangway on the starboard side has the doors open awaiting you. Please leave the boat immediately. nature caller, and since it also affected She Who Must Be Obeyed, a rapid retirement to Seacom Terminal was necessary, which by the way has been rather well done up. But quite a nice job.
Thanks, lads.
Considering the place. And so now we're just parked up to the north by the new tunnel's vent shaft, and we're watching the Daffy going back into Liverpool from another point of view. Oh well, so we carry on. So what do you want to do when you leave school then?
I like wildlife, so I want to do something to do with animals and stuff.
Fair enough.
I'm in year 6 in September. Uh-huh. And I'm in year 8 in September. Okay. He's turned around. I can see a train that's all the way from Birkenhead.
That's not Birkenhead, that's Liverpool. Birkenhead's that way. Container boat. Wow. China shipping line. I like dogs.
I like dogs. Well, my favourite animals are crocodiles, snakes, and dolphins, but my real proper animal is a tiger, a chocolate tiger. Uh-huh. White.
They were right. That's a nice little container boat. China shipping, if you couldn't see it, coming out from the Seaforth container terminal. Strange, that little dock takes more cargo than the whole of the Merseyside dock system ever used to do before containerization. And I wonder what that was cargo. But still, here's Daffy coming up to join the party again.
You are recycling. some sand, you know where your best going? Down that road. And see that white pub there?
Yeah.
That white house down there, there's always sand down there.
Yeah, we were down there before.
Yeah, the ferry.
So after saying our fond farewells to the Royal Daffodil, remember she was originally a symphony called the Overchurch, we finally retired to the mouth of the river, looking out onto Liverpool Bay, and see the China boat pushing off quite nicely. We're now at a place called New Brighton, which is an old holiday resort, seaside town. Before the war it had a tower which equaled Blackpool or the Eiffel. Now, because of all the NIMBYs, it's just a load of rubbish. We're at a point called Fort Murchock, where you'll shortly see a little swing past the fort, which protected the mouth of the Mersey through a couple of wars or whatever. Okay, well now we wait for the P&O ferry. and seeing the P&O job come out and quite happily settle down to wander over towards Ireland and places equally strange. It is time for us to take the correct steps and step off in good order to leave the Mersey until next time. I hope you've enjoyed this little thing and maybe you'll have a look at a few more. If you want to see some stills all over the Birkenhead ferries, Mersey ferries, you are welcome to go and have a look at amerseyferry.co.uk. It ain't commercial. Bye bye now.